everybody. Joe Costello in the lanes at the 70th Toyota U.S. Nationals. That's right. Super Cup. Get in here. Come. We got Chase Freeman here. You ready?
I'm ready. I think so.
He's ready. We're all ready.
All ready.
Check out this round one matchup. Super Comp. You got former world champion Ray Miller III going up against Anson Brown. Antron Brown's son earlier this year won $50,000 in a big money bracket race. How about that for a first round matchup in our 890 index class? And we're going to hang with this run, this whole run, here on this In the Lanes episode. Then we'll head back. You can look at Ray Miller getting ready. Look at Anson Brown, the Streamlight machine. Look at Hanksomers and Macro Tools. Ray Miller, we featured this car a couple of weeks ago on Attention in the Pits, and now they're rolling out. They took their time runs yesterday. Round one here on Thursday. Two cars will be running in the final round right around 3 p.m. on Monday, Labor Day, days from now. The biggest and longest drag race in the world. Ray Miller backing up into the water box, dancing over on the left-hand side. Let's follow Anson Brown through his burnout. Those that don't know, Super Comp is a great category that we would call relatively budget controlled because of the 890 index. All of these cars are quicker than the 890 index. Slow down into that index. It's drag racing. You want to get to the finish line first without running under the index. And that creates a whole lot of strategy that happens on the top end. You want to have a great reaction time. 000 is perfect, just like all categories. Get down there, take the stripe, get there first. Don't run under 890. A lot of gamesmanship. Ray Miller, the KG veteran. Anson Brown over on the left-hand side. Antron walks just from inside the wall. They're both pre-stage. Let's see who goes in first. It's Anson, gonna try to play any mind games with the champ. No way, he's in. Ray going in, tickles the ball. Anson Brown, Antron going crazy on the starting line. Antron Brown gets the win with his son, Anson Brown. Let's go talk to him. We are live here on the starting line. He just knocked out a world champ round one in Indy. How you feel, Pop?
I'm happy for Anson. We knew it was going to be a tough race, but Anson's been on the tree. We got tuned up at Bowling Green and been working on his Super Comp combination. And we know we couldn't play no game, so we had to run dead on. So it felt real good to get the dial in right and get those numbers right to make it do that deal. And Anson just does his job all the time. So I'm super proud of the kid. Him and Dylan, his cousin, they've been doing this all week. And by herself, all I've been doing is watching. They're doing it all. So it's really
cool.
Keep
it up. Keep up the good work.
Thank you.
There he goes. Antron Brown, our three-time champ. Look at this. Door slammer and Super Comp. They do exist. Now we're going to head out. The family members taking the runs. You look around. The burnout is so important. Got to see that burnout. Got to see that Toolist Blind Squirrel Racing. The thing about Indy is that people prepare for this race all year long. All year goes into this one event. Oh, look, it's Jason Galvin. All right, here's the story of Jason Galvin and his Getrix machine. First of all, the Tom Bayer, you got to hang with Galvin, don't we? The announcing brethren, this guy is going to be on the mic in there with me. What am I doing? He's out here running round one at the U.S. Nationals. Let's hang with Galvin. This is going to be kind of in a different In the Lanes, guys. So Tom Bayer Drag Racing School fields these cars. And Galvin and you and anybody out there can pay to sign up and be a part of it. Like, here's another one, part of the team, Tom Bayer Driving School. Galvin getting a little tune-up, getting a conversation. Check out the conversation with Tom Bayer. Make sure the fuel cap is on, the air bottle is open. Jason Galvin just got the ready from Tom Mayer, and we're rolling up. Going up against Brian Pretzler over there on the right-hand side. No slouch by any means. Got right trailers. The sharpened Pretzler machine. Why not take a moment to focus? Jason Galvin ran this race a year ago. Went like four rounds. Did very well. Didn't run the car till Bowling Green last week. He went to the final round. Went to the final round of the Bowling Green Divisional. And now, he has a very tough customer. The Sharpen Pretzler construction machine of Brian Pretzler. You're going to be watching all of this on NHRA TV right now. You can buy a weekend pass. You can buy a weekend pass and see all of this right now, immediately. So backing up from the burnout, Galvin with a shorter burnout. If we can get the tree and the shot when they launch, everybody watch the top part of the circle, the pre-stage bulbs. Whichever one goes out first probably had the better of the two reaction times. ...70 years of the U.S. Nationals, 30 years of Supercomp as a category. No racer has won Supercomp at Indy three times. Bunch of two-time winners. Tom Mayer checks the machine. It's in the hands of the driver. Brian Pretzler already up there. Pre-stage, sitting pre-stage. Galvin slowly moving in. Still a little bit behind the starting line. He likes that pre-stage bulb. Like gunfighters in the Old West, stepping into the street. One will advance. Pretzler's in. Galvin. Breakout, both drivers. Galvin, 887.2, under by more. Pretzler with an 889 at 185. That's the kind of racing you're going to be seeing here all weekend long. Again,